Hello everyone, this is Groove Sim, and I'm here with some more For Honor gameplay. Right now we're going to be doing a skirmish match. I did this, when was that? It was a few days ago, Tuesday, maybe? And I'm just getting caught up on my videos. Takes a little bit get back in the flow of things, you know. I've been kind of letting some videos pile up, you know, and not editing for a couple of days, and so actually more than that. So I'm trying to get caught up today, and right now, this is one of the contract orders was Bloody Skirmish, and I think you had to get like 50 takedowns. I don't remember exactly, but as you can see, I'm breaking in my Nobushi. Yeah, I finally figured out. You know, I got her name right. Kept calling her everything but Nobushi. This is the map Village. Sure, some of you recognize it. And right off into the action, and straight away killed. New character trying to figure out, you know, her moves. You know, she's got a lot of jabby jabs and stabby stabs with that long spear, and can do some bleed damage if you use her right. Very quick, agile. In almost rhythmic, you know, in the way she dances with that spear. Oh yeah, that's another thing about skirmish is you have the minions on the map, and there are some captains around as well. NPC. Captains for both sides. Yeah, one of the things I've been having difficulty doing is change my attack from right to left, you know, in fluid succession. I don't hold the right stick all the time. Sometimes I've gotten in a bit of a bad habit where I'm not using the stick to aim my swing. Instead, I'm just kind of swinging, you know, and that's really hurting me. I ran right into that. Two of the opponents in the kid's age just sliced and diced me. I was down on health. Try to revive at least one of my teammates. But this is skirmish. It's not needed. It's not like elimination. Of the two modes, I prefer elimination, because there's a sense of finality. If you don't get revived, or if you get executed or knocked off a cliff or whatever, that's it. Round over for you, and you gotta hope your teammates can somehow pull out a win for the round. And it can turn, you know. There's more at stake, more on the line. This skirmish, I've learned, can last a long time, because I mean, it could go the time limit. I forget how many points we need. What is it? 500? To maybe it's 1,000. You know what? I don't remember. I should know that. I haven't played a lot of skirmish though. is my excuse. Played Elimination, Duel, Brawl, and Dominion. And the only reason I was playing Skirmish in this was just to fulfill that contract. And stamina, of course. Early on, a character that I just recruited, you know, no stamina. I gotta level her up and get the gear, and there's a lot of grinding involved for each and every hero. Lots and lots of grinding just to be able to upgrade to the better weapons, better armor, and give myself better attributes and buffs, you know, for stamina and revenge and all that. Sprint. Maybe a bit. I don't know. It's still early. My early impressions, though, are that maybe there's a bit too much weight, a bit too much, what am I trying to say? I think there's just too much grinding, is what I'm trying to say, man. I mean, you should grind, you should earn it. But I think too much weight has been put on that. And I think the reason for that is maybe Ubisoft would like people to spend real world money to unlock all those crates and level up their attributes and buffs a little quicker than they would if they just earned it naturally throughout the grinding process. And you know, that's one theory anyway. I already noticed too that you know, I got this game, let's see, it was a week ago. It was on Friday, so it's been 8 days. And the game came out February 14th. So that's just a couple of weeks, you know, that in between the time it was released and the time I picked it up. Here's what I've noticed. There seems to be a drop-off, a steady, alarming sort of drop-off in the player count and the interest in For Honor. And I know there are a couple of reasons for that, or I believe there are a couple of reasons for that. You know, I've seen other people mainly talk about the connectivity issues, things like that, peer-to-peer, being an outdated and overused method for publishers and devs to, as I get dropped again, to, I guess, I don't know, save time and money, you know, on their end. But what ends up happening is if you have unstable online, you know, due to servers, peer-to-peer, people will just get sick and tired of it after a while and drop out. Okay, that's one issue. The other issue, as I see it, is Ubisoft is actually competing with themselves. Because Ghost Recon Wildlands just dropped. For Honor barely gained any momentum, you know, it barely got going, and now it's competing against one of Ubisoft's other titles in Wildlands, and I don't understand that. But you see, we win. I had a modest 9-3 there. My bot teammates outshined me in every way. I like playing the bots. And this is, I could have chosen to go with players, but what I found going with players in skirmish mode, it's just ridiculous. And I mean, especially if you're going, if you're teamed up with players that are more experienced or just hopping around the map, they got better buffs, everything is working out for them. They're grabbing all the kills, you know, and I'm like, you know, I'm just chasing the whole time trying to get kills. So that's why I decided to disable matchmaking and do this with the bots. But anyway, you know, I'm not sure Ubisoft had the best strategy for when they dropped For Honor or when they dropped Wildlands, because it's one thing to compete against other publishers and other devs, it's another thing when you're competing against yourself, and that's what they're doing. And pretty damn quick now, in the month of March, we have Andromeda, you know. And if people on the PS4, you know, they've got Horizon, they've got what else? Oh man! Nier Automata and things like that, which has received high praise and looks like a cool game. So, you know, because this is a multi-platform game, and it's going up against some fairly stiff competition in the month of March. And you know, it's bad enough again if the title's going up against other companies, but when you throw in your own damn titles in the mix to compete against it, you know, Wildlands is drawing interest and base away from For Honor. It's like For Honor it's a far more deserving game, I think, because it's a cool premise. It's a really cool fighting style, and the mechanics are cool. The map's really nice. The whole premise behind For Honor is a winner in my mind. But the problem is, Ubisoft is shooting themselves in the foot twice with the connection issues, the server issues, and competing against their own titles, you know. And I think that is hurting it in the long run. And I'm going to keep on playing it. For me, I'm still like green, man. I'm really raw, and I barely got going in this game, and I don't even want to consider Wildlands right now, you know. In fact, it might be some time before I do. I'll tell you what I'm going to pick up before I pick up Wildlands or a lot of other games, and that's going to be Mass Effect Andromeda, because I love the Mass Effect series. And, you know, I played all three, and now Andromeda's dropping, and it looks even more spectacular in some ways. I don't know if it's going to live up to it, you know, but what I've seen and what's available to do in that game, oh my god, that's a game that is going to demand a lot of attention and a lot of hours in a day, you know. So that's going to draw someone like me away from a game like For Honor as well. I'm not going to, and not completely necessarily, but certainly I won't play as much For Honor when I start playing Mass Effect Andromeda. So there's like this limited time span, this frame of time that Ubisoft had to get For Honor on the charts, man, on everybody's radar, and launch it strong and start gaining momentum and build and expand that base, cultivate the following, you know. And they're screwing it up, in my opinion. They are screwing it up. And that's nothing new for Ubisoft. They've screwed up so many titles in recent memory that, you know, and this title is more quality. I think it's higher quality than, say, Division and The Crew and titles like that. And it deserves a lot more attention and a better fate than what it may end up with. And that's a damn shame. I mean, if you're a company that has a business model that which insists on online and multiplayer being the focus, you better bring it. You better put everything you can behind it to make it work. And don't, like, saturate the market with title after title after title, man. You got to build communities around these titles, you know? And that's, I don't see that happen. It's like, here's our game, you know, we hyped it to all high heaven. Hope you enjoy. Spend your 60 or 90 or 100 or whatever you spend on the gold, and this is what you get. By the way, Wildlands is out. Hey, you gonna buy that? Hey, you know, I mean, come on, man. See, the thing that makes titles that are multiplayer and online successful is they build a following. It becomes a community, a huge community that's cultivated and expands, you know? There are more successful, let's call them community titles, on PC than there are for console. And I think that mentality, that mindset, that approach for pubs and devs has to change for console. To make these titles more, or at least better received and more successful, and just taken seriously, I guess, more taken seriously than they are. Because if you just saturate the market, you know, with title after title after title, it's like, you know, before you know it, it's like the lifespan of a title is about 2 weeks to a month at that point. Ridiculous, man. That's just not going to work. That whole approach needs to change, I think, especially in the console market. You know, not so much PC. Although a lot of these titles we're talking about do end up on PC, and, you know, there's that. But then there are a lot of other titles that are successful because they're not coming out with another title on the heels, you know, like month after month. Just absolutely saturating the market. It's just this freaking deluge of and never-ending stream of titles from Ubisoft. And it's like quantity over high value and high success. That didn't even make sense what I just said. But anyway, I'm going to shut up about that. I've been talking about that this whole video. Yeah, I spent the day I played this match. I spent the day unlocking new heroes. I unlocked a handful, and now I'm up to. I think I have two or three remaining to recruit, and then I'll have them all until the new heroes drop. And right now, you know, I gotta say, my favorites still tend to be the go-tos, the standbys, you know, like the Raider for the Vikings. I like the Night Warden. I like the Peacekeeper Assassin for the Knights. I like, let's see, the Raider. Conqueror is okay, although that one, there seems, for me, it's the bots really do well, especially higher level bots with the Conqueror. Players, not so much. I haven't ran into too many players that use the Conqueror to great advantage. I'm sure there are some, I just haven't ran into them yet. But that's what I'd like to perfect, because I'm telling you what, man, the Conqueror, out of all of them, for me, is the toughest to defend against and attack. By far. I'm going to keep playing this game regardless whether it's online or just me and the bots. You know, I spent $60 for this, so I'm going to get my money's worth. Let me know what you think of the game. You know, I mean, what do you think about the community, and have you ran into a lot of online issues, and, you know, what do you think of Ubisoft's marketing strategy in terms of, you know, releasing a game on top of another game on top of a game, you know? Kind of crowding the market with their own titles and crowding each other. And whatever else. I mean, what do you think of the game overall? And, you know, I played story mode. I've got a story mode playlist going. Yeah, story mode, really tacky. It's Attack On. Some good fighting, you know, good challenges, but not it's not a top-notch story, let's just put it that way. And with this setting, man, they could have done a hell of a lot better for a story. Hell of a lot better. If I sound critical, it's because I care. I do. And I do appreciate the game overall, but it's just disappointing that it might be stunted a little bit. So they're 8-4. The bot up top, 18-2. I didn't see which one that was. 18-2. It was Ponin. By dude, I mean bot was Ponin. So that takes care of the skirmish, and I have yet one more skirmish match coming up next. That's in the next video. Just to finish up the bloody skirmish contract. And here you see me deploying assets. This is something I've been cognizant of, and I've been trying to deploy. If you deploy in the territory that you just fought in, you get bonuses. There, I didn't deploy. But anyway, I'll see you next video. Stay groovy.